Hello, everybody. Good evening. So this is Onkwayo speaking, and I just thought to make a very simple, relatable video on how to navigate FTX. I've tried using FTX for a couple of my trading, especially since I am an active trader. I do intraday trading, and I also do spot trading. And I just want to show you a couple of things I found out. And it's easy to navigate. So first of all, don't get carried away with all of the features on FTX. If you're a starter, if you're a beginner, just know what you want to target. You want to target how to deposit, you want to target how to buy, you want to target how to sell, you want to target how to withdraw. As simple as that. Then for skilled traders, professional traders, intraday traders, I would also show you some features here that has helped me navigate this market, you know, properly. So you trying to get money, first thing you want to do is you want to know how to get money into your account, right? So, and I'll try and explain as much as I can explain here. So these are your current balances. These are deposits if you have any, and you can make a deposit, right? So I made a couple of deposits here, and this is just, I just created this account just for the purpose of this tutorial. It takes between a day to a week to get verified, and that will be the only way you can withdraw. If you have done your KYC, you know your customer, then withdraw out to then positions. If you have any current positions in the market, positions means whether you have any order that is running, you can do that, right? So now making a deposit, if you're trying to make a deposit, you can deposit using fiat, deposit in crypto. If you want to deposit using crypto, if you want to go through the stable, the USD Tita. So USD Tita means the United States dollar, that is the value of the United States dollar is tied to crypto, right? So it's almost the same thing, just little percentage differences. But just know that your USD Tita is the value of your US dollar, but it is in crypto, right? It's tied to same value, so it's a stable coin. So most of the time when you hear a lot of crypto enthusiasts that will say, oh, it's high time with Tita, is maybe they are projecting volatility in the market, and you want to convert all of their tokens to a stable coin that is not affected by price movement, right? So if you want to deposit, you do that through network, and there are a couple of network. I would advise that every time you want to deposit money, whether it's using Tita, preferably use the Tron network. The Tron network takes about $1 to deposit, and the Ethereum network is costly. You would hardly find anywhere that uses Ethereum network deposit, you know, money in the active wallet, right? So you can do that. If you want to then deposit using US dollar itself, not the Tita version, you can also do that too, right? You can deposit via card, you can deposit anything. So if you're depositing via card, if you're in Nigeria, you might find a bit of problem using this, but if you're outside the country, whether in the UK, in the US, or in Europe, it'll be easy for you to, you know, deposit via card. You just add your card and you can fund your FTX account, you know, through this method. And once you do that, once you're able to fund the account like that, you would see it reflect in deposits. Right now, there's another very important thing you might want to do. You can, you know, create multiple accounts, which is a good way for you to protect yourself as an active trader. So I can decide to say this account would be just for futures trading, right? I create a sub account for futures trading. I can create another account and then, you know, call that account Degen mode. So Degen mode means Degen mode is a mode, it is a term you use in crypto space anytime you are trying to trade without sense. You are trading senselessly, you're trying to make huge returns in very small time. That's Degen mode, right? So you can create as many sub accounts you can do, and again, it costs zero. So this is one feature about FTX I enjoy a lot. It costs zero to, you know, send funds back and forth, your main account and your sub account. Yeah, I hope this makes sense. So once I'm able to, if I want to make a deposit into my Degen mode, I can, you know, send from my main account here. I can make a deposit from here, you know, from my main account, right? So I can transfer, you know, account to account into what's the name, into my sub account, right? So transfer balances. Can you see? So you transfer balances. I want to transfer USD onto from my main account. My main account shows 500 USD to my futures account. I see to my futures account, what am I transferring? I'll transfer 200 USD, it will reflect immediately 200 USD in my futures account. It costs zero, right? You see the futures account, you see 200 USD. My main account, you now see 300 USD there. That's what you have here, right? So since I don't want to do it this way, I'll just transfer my money back to transfer my USD back to my main account and just max it out and transfer everything. You see the balance reflect back to 500. So my main account 500. So this is a very good feature you can use. So you can decide to say any money I'm putting in futures, so that it's not when I lose all my money in futures, it will affect my main account. Don't use your main account for all of your trades. But I haven't said that how to fund. You can also withdraw using the same method. If you've made your money and you want to convert, you can convert back to USDT, withdraw using USDT, or you convert back to USD. USD is the fiat, USDT is the crypto. Fiat means traditional currency, right? Can be naira, dollar, euro, pounds. That's fiat. All right, so there's another very interesting features I wanted to show you, which is if you want to take the issue of crypto serious, trading serious. Let me check if this is still recording, so I'm not just okay, great. You want to take the issue of trading serious. Now this is another very important feature, right? Is you can lend your money. I love this part about FTX. I love this part about FTX. You can lend your money. So if you have your USD, fiat, right? If you have your fiat and you have where is it? Okay, I'll get it now. There's a part there. Oh great. So now these are the balances. You have under your wallet, you have these balances. You can lend out your money, so you don't just leave money sitting there, right? And if you have tokens that you want to keep for a long time, you can lend them out. You see the percentage. If you're lending out your dollar, you can lend out and you can enable spot margin trading, right? Because I've not enabled it. If you want to lend out, you know how much you'll be getting in return, 10%. You enable it and you're able to lend your money out, and you see your percentage you get. This is way better than traditional savings on traditional banking, right? So now let me just go straight to the point why I made this video, how to buy, right? So if you want to buy, go to the market, right? You're going to the market, there are different ways you can buy. All of these are options for trading the market. If you are not an experienced trader, if you don't know anything about trading, just stick with spot trading. Experienced traders use perpetual contracts. So perpetual contract, traditionally, there's something we call contract trading, right? So with time, as contract trading began to metamorphose, we had contract trades that do not expire, and they are called perpetual. So traditionally, that's why it's called a contract. A contract is meant to expire, but in 3 months, in 6 months, or a year, or a couple of weeks. So when you buy contracts on whether the stock market or the financial market, you have an expiry date where the contract expires. But in the crypto market now, we also have a revised form of contract trading, which is called perpetual contract, the one that doesn't expire. Right, so I'm going to explain this a bit, and this is for the sake of professional traders. But if you know nothing about trading and you just want to buy and sell, you should just stick to you should just stick to spot trading. Now, for you to spot trade, there's something called the base pair, right? See value at the back, this unit at the back is called the base pair, and you see them. The base pairs are either in USD or USDT. Remember what I taught you, the difference between USD and USDT is. Yes, that's a base pair, right? So, and you can use different base pair. You can decide to say, okay, I have BTC and I want to use the base pair of BTC, right? But for now, let's just stick with USDT. Let's stick with this, right? So this base pair for USDT. Let me remove this as option. Let me put this as option. 1, 2, right? Remove this. So we are just concerned about two base pairs, the USD and the USDT base pair. So currently, remember, all I have funded here is 500 USD for Solana, right? So if I click Sol USD and I want to buy that, right, I can buy from my main account. I can decide to buy from my main account. Now, you can either buy or sell. Now, I'm going to teach you how to navigate this. So I understand, right? So there are different orders. There are things we call order type. You can use a market order. You can use limit order. Market order means you see all of these fluctuating colors and all their order books. So there are other books whereby you have traders that have sitting orders or orders that are executing presently in the market. So if you choose market order, you are telling, the market to give you the best price presently. That's what you are telling market. Give me the best price presently. So it's just going to execute like that. But that's not the best way to trade. So that's why I would normally advise get some bit of technical knowledge before you know how to trade, before you can trade the market, right? So if that's why you say, okay, let me put a limit. So if you put limits, you are saying, oh, okay, do not execute my order unless it gets to this limit. I don't know if this makes sense. So the current price of Solana here is 240, right? You're saying, okay, I will leave it at 220, right? If it doesn't get to 220, don't execute this order. Now you can use this slider to decide what amount of your account you want to use to trade. You see, when I slide it out, when I maximize everything, when I put 100%, it shows the maximum of my account, right? This is approximately $500. So you can decide to use 25% of your account, 50%, or you can slide it at will, right? So you can place your order. Once you place your order, you see it reflected. Once you place your order, you see it reflected under open orders, because it will not. You are saying don't execute this order unless it gets to 220. I don't know if this makes sense. So if you place this order, right, you go to open orders and you see it's not executing yet. So anytime this price drops and it drops to 220, it will execute, right? So because I don't want to buy this now, I'll just cancel, this order. So now that's how you place order and that's how you buy. If you want to sell, the same thing. So that means if you are selling, it means you want to get profit, right? You want to sell and you don't want to, sell just at any price. This sell can be a take profit. You want to say, okay, because I bought Solana low, I'll take profit at 280. So you are saying if it doesn't get to 280, you see that there is nothing that will show here because I don't have Solana here. I don't even have bought Solana, I can sell, showing you. So all you are saying is limit order again is if it doesn't get to 280, do not execute my order. This makes sense, right? So now that's how you buy and sell. Right, so once you have that, and if you sell it, once you sell it, it will sell your Solana and convert it to USD. You see the USD where you see it under your wallet, you see it balance under your wallet, and you can withdraw the same way I taught you how to withdraw. Right, you can withdraw, you can convert it back to USDT and send to somebody that maybe a third party wallet or whatever. But the important thing is you know how to get it to USD, the base pair, either USD or USDT, and you know how to get it out. And you know how to buy and sell. So for the advanced part, right, let me go to the market and talk about investment. So we have other parts you can trade. You can trade leverage tokens. So leverage tokens is it's also a part of is also a flavor of future trading, right? But this time around, you are not under futures trading here. You are the one selecting leverage. Leverage is, in simple terms, leverage is the degree of market exaggeration. So if you are going $10, how do we exaggerate the market? By how much do we exaggerate the market, right? Whether in increase or in decrease. Yes. So if time permits, I'll do a separate video for futures trading and leverage trading. But for this, you know that if you don't have the balls to go into futures trading, but you want to know how to, play with leverage, you might come to leverage tokens. So you are saying that if you choose bull USD, you are saying that I'm predicting that Bitcoin will go on long, and I want to use a 3x leverage, right? But you can decide what leverage you want to use. You can use 1x leverage. You can let me remove all of this and leave it. Okay, great. So you're saying I'm saying that bear, okay, this is shorting, right? So that's why you see alt bear USDT. That means you want to short. Short means you are predicting that the market will go, down. Now this is daily change. So anybody that has shorted today, you see that this is the increase in the market that they've gotten short. So if you're longing, you see that the long the your longing the market has been on a negative because the market has been on a downtrend today. Now that's that. So volatility is a bit different. Volatility is just has nothing to do with the unit price. Volatility is just they're measuring the percentage of spike or reduction, right? So I'll just ask you to just, avoid all of this. Now, stock, it doesn't concern us, but then stock is what crypto exchanges have been doing recently is they've been trying to integrate some some bit of stock trading into their platform so that they can have a more robust trading platform. So if you're trying to trade futures or perpetual contracts on stock trade, whether you want to spot trade them or future trade them, the options are here. Just the same way you address normal crypto tokens, you can do that here. But let me just, you know, round off this with futures and trading that I spoke about. So let's look at Solana too. We've been on Solana, so let's just keep it at that, right? So the same thing, but this time around you are trading on exaggerated mode. Now a couple of more options here, and I'll just try and explain them as I should, and things you should look out for. So again, you want to make sure that you're not trading with your major account, right? And one thing I love that FTX has done is how they've been able to integrate TradingView into the platform. So you can, and I think the indicators here are free. You don't have a limit, right? If you're using TradingView itself, you'd see a limit of 3 indicators, but here they are free, right? But I would advise you that before you start trading futures, if you don't know what to do, don't do leverage trading. Don't trade futures except you have somebody tutoring you, except you spend time learning. I said, you know what you're doing, right? So now you can decide what leverage that you want to trade with. So if I'm buying, I'm saying, oh, okay, this is let me oh great. Now I can flip the mode here, right? So if I'm buying here or I want to sell this contract this time around, how this is different from your spot trading is that here you don't need to have the asset itself. Don't forget that your spot trading, you have to have the asset before you sell. But on contract, you don't need to have the asset before you sell. All you need to put in is a collateral. And this time around, you see what collateral is. The collateral is $500, which is what I have in my main account. And that's because I'm on my main account. Don't forget, don't use your main account to trade. So if I change this account to futures account, you see that what I have as total collateral here is zero. So what you should do preferably is, if you want to trade futures, move your money to futures account, then trade on that, you know, account, so that you don't risk your entire account, right? So I don't take any. Okay, let me just do it. Let me just, you know, trade with my main account and pick a position right here while we are, you know, in this call, right? So now if I want to use this and I want to be on times one leverage. I want to be on times one leverage, and I'm saying, oh, okay, this is the price, current price. Don't forget what I taught us about limit order, market order, all of this. So you don't need all of this. The only ones you need, I'll tell you different. What you need here is limit order, stop market, and take profits. You see the many, if you don't know what you're doing, don't gamble with them. This is just a starter pack for you if you're coming to trading. I've taught you what limit order means, and that is the same concept as spot trading. Market order, same thing. Stop market and stop limit. So stop market is, it would not stop limit. Why you should not use stop limit is, if you put stop limit, it's going to leave your price on, it's going to execute your price on this order book. It's until the order book execute down to your price, the last price, that's when it gets you off. And the downside of stop limit is that when there is a huge negative trend and there is a huge spike in volatility on the downside, it might take you out. It might miss your stop limit. It might miss your signal on the stop limit, and you know, you would be in loss, and you would think that you've activated, you know, a risk management system, whereas it has missed it. So effective is a stop market over stop limit, right? So you can use all of that. You can select them differently. But if I flip this, you're able to put all of them on the same, you know, page. So let me use a 2x leverage here, right? Let me use a 2x leverage and try and buy on this position. I'll just, you know, execute a market buy. So you see what we are talking about, right? So let me just execute a market buy. So limit order. Let me use a market order. Let me change this for a while. Let me use a market order, right? Let me say 241. Let me say 241. I don't want this to execute. Let me use a limit order. Great. Let me use a limit order. Sorry. I'll just go live. So I'll say, I don't want this order to execute until it comes to 240, right? And I want to take profit when it gets to 245, right? Then my stop loss, I want to get out of the market if it gets to 225. So you see how much you would lose. So can you see this is percentage 6%, this 2% gain. You see how much you'd lose if you do that, right? So when if you execute that, if you come down, you see the mark price, all of that, and you see all of the details of your trade here. Immediately you execute that and you how much of your account are you going into? You see 25% of your account. Normally, I make it a thumb of rule that I don't go more than 5% of my account in a trade, right? If you say 5% of your account, you see how much you are using from your account. So if I enter this trade, I would currently be using $24 from my account, and if I hit stop loss, I'll lose $1.50. If I hit and take profit, I'll gain 50 cents, right? So that is because of I'm using a small leverage. So if I place my order, it will fall under open orders. I don't know if this makes sense. So if I do that, let me see. Great. Oh, great. Solid. Limit order 241.00. Take profit 240, 250, 250.00. Stop loss to 20, right? Let me use 38 USD, right? And place this order. Once I place this order, you see it come under, open order, right? And now this is the beauty of this is why I like what's the name? This is why I like FTX. So you can move all of this. You can move all of this even while you are in trade. You can edit your position even while you're in trade. For other exchanges that I have seen, other exchanges I have seen, once you've placed it, is either you cancel or what, you cannot edit in trade. So if I want to edit this my price, I can edit it here, and I can change the size, change the price and all, which is a good one. I think, has it triggered? Oh great, that's triggered. And you see now that it has triggered, my position has triggered. You see whether I am in what's the name, whether I am in profit or I'm in loss, right? So you'd see it reflected on the chart, right? So if I open my trigger orders, you see my stop market, my take profit. I can edit them even while in that trade, right? So let me see. Great. Let me see if I can. Yeah, you can decide to edit your stop market and your take profit even while you are in the trade. Even while you are in the trade. Alternatively, you can even, if you go to your position and you want to, boost, boost about what you have made or whatever. If you export this, you can show how much you've gained, whatever. You can share the time, share the leverage. You can decide to share your percentage. You can decide to share leverage. If you don't want them to know how much leverage you're using, you can show. You don't want them to know when you open the trade, you can remove that. If you want to, if you don't want to show all of this information, you can just share as whatsoever. So yeah, this is just introductory lesson on how to navigate the platform. Let me know what else you'd want me to show or what else I missed. I just did this in a hurry, just for anybody that just wants to trade very quickly, how they know how to run trades and open trades and whatever. So let me know what I should, make a tutorial on, and let me know what you think in the comment section or whatever. All right, thank you for your time.